You're listening to an exclusive Mining Maven podcast interview, which is for information and educational purposes only and should not be considered as investment advice or a recommendation to buy shares in the company featured. Today's interview is with Dr. Kerem Senna, Managing Director of Ariana Resources, and was recorded on Thursday, the 10th of May, 2012. Kerem, thank you very much for giving up some of your time today to talk to us at Mining Maven.
Thank you, Malcolm. It's a pleasure.
We wanted to catch up with you to give you the opportunity to update investors with developments at Ariana, and we've got a few questions for you. So kicking off with the first one, can you please explain the significance of the recently published results from Salimbash in northeastern Turkey and your joint venture with what was originally European Goldfields, but since the acquisition is now with Eldorado?
Sure. The drilling that we announced last quarter concerned the results of the drilling program that we'd undertaken during the course of 2011. That drilling program was focused in the periphery of what we'd already understood to be the main Salimbash system, which at surface we'd identified as a series of breccia pipes. But we later discovered during the course of our drilling activity that we've got a fairly gently dipping sheet of gold mineralization with silver that runs between limestones and overlying volcanic rocks. Now, we've followed this sheet of mineralization down. We haven't closed it off either to the east or to the south. So that's an area where we'd want to focus additional drilling in the future. But the results that we reported are very good indeed. We're very happy about them. Some highlights there, 9.5 meters at 6.48 grams per ton gold with silver. 11.3 meters at 4.98 grams per ton gold with silver. These are all in line with previous drilling results that we've announced for the Salimbash system. And the significance of these results is that the Salimbash discovery was made in the periphery of the Ardala copper gold moly porphyry, which occurs lower down in the valley. No doubt it's this porphyry that's been driving a series of hydrothermal systems in the periphery. And Salimbash is just an exceptionally high-grade version of those sort of systems. And we have no doubt that there's more to come out of the Salimbash story.
Since European Goldfields were taken over by Eldorado, how does this impact, if at all, your ongoing relationship on the ground?
The ongoing relationship will not be impacted. There's just obviously been a switchover of operating team in country. But what we're trying to do is maintain the existing core competencies within the joint venture entity. And we're actually in the process of discussions now with Eldorado as to how we drive this joint venture forward. But we understand that Eldorado are keen on the joint venture, and they want to remain involved in the joint venture. So we're just working through the detail of the final arrangement at this point in time.
Thanks, Kerem. Can you outline for investors what other exploration work is ongoing in Western Turkey, particularly that utilising your in-house drilling team and equipment, and for exploration in the round, what news flow can investors expect during the rest of 2012?
Yes, right now we've got a drilling program underway. The drilling started off with about 2,000 metres of drilling on Kızıltepe. That was drilling on some additional vein zones that we'd identified, or potential vein zones that we'd identified in geophysics and through other methods. And then we've just moved the rig over to a new prospect that we call Kepez West, which is located just a few kilometres to the northeast of Kızıltepe. And we've just started drilling the first few holes at that location. So that seems to be going well. We intend to keep the rig active on Kepez West, complete that program, and then later on bring the rig round to the Karakavak prospect, and then perhaps later on in the year, even further to the northeast of Kızıltepe itself, we have the Kızılçukur property, which we had acquired last year from Kefi Minerals. So perhaps in the last quarter of this year, we'd be drilling on the Kızılçukur property. Other than drilling, we're continuing our exploration in the vicinity of the Red Rabbit project and its periphery. Although I know that you're going to come on to a question about license auctions, a lot of that exploration was directed towards identifying targets in the license round.
As far as the company's strategic plan's concerned, how does that stand with regard to building a portfolio of exploration ground, both within Turkey and perhaps other territories?
Yes, well, we're always on the lookout for new opportunities, particularly in our core area of Western Turkey. The exploration that we undertook during 2010 and 2011 was directed at identifying the potential of various key areas within Western Turkey. And a lot of that effort, of course, was directed towards identifying properties that may come up in auction. And some of those we've been involved in participating in those auctions. But then other than that, we've retained interest in looking out for other opportunities across Turkey. And obviously we have our interest in Tigris Resources, 13% stake in that company. And Tigris is essentially doing the same thing, going through the same sort of process as we are with regional exploration to identify targets in that region. In terms of outside of Turkey, yes, you know, we do look at things from time to time. I mean, into Southeastern Europe and into parts of Central Asia, but so far nothing sort of stood out, and we'd have to be very sure of potential in such a location before we ventured further afield. We're quite happy where we are, particularly focused on Western Turkey.
Thanks, Kerim. And moving on to that question regarding license auctions in Turkey, how's your participation in this process progressing? And how could this contribute to the company's strategic objectives with regard to your exploration portfolio?
We've participated in several auctions. We'd identified several targets. I think we'd identified about 14 targets at the start of the auction process. Those auctions have been progressing from January, and we've got a further auction coming up during the course of this month. And we have been successful. We've acquired several new licenses. And our intention is to explore those licenses during the course of this year.
Kerim, can you remind us of your operational objectives with regard to gold production from the Red Rabbit project, and how, in broad terms, are operations on the ground progressing?
Well, the operations on the ground are progressing very well at the moment. We're back into sort of full swing on a number of aspects of the feasibility study. And we're just progressing the continuation now of the environmental impact assessment. We've been liaising with various government departments on permitting of the project, and we're in positive progress in that regard. We're also continuing with exploration right on top of the Kızıltepe prospect. So we're just completing an IP resistivity survey plus ground mag, and that will go on to help us define deeper level drilling targets. Because we believe that there is a longer term potential beyond the currently designated mine life of about 8 years, and we'd rather identify those sort of deeper level opportunities sooner rather than later. But as the project stands, where we are with the feasibility, we're comfortable with that. A lot of the work on the engineering and process engineering side of things has been completed. We've completed the detailed mine scheduling for the open pit on a 3-monthly basis, and it's all sort of stacking together quite nicely at this point in time. There's obviously still a lot of work to do, but you know, we're working on increasing our speed on some aspects of that where we can. Some things have been held back, as we made the market aware. We've been waiting for forestry permits in the tailings dam area. We are in process of securing those in the near future, I hope. But we've not got any major hurdles in front of us. These are all things that we can work through in time. In the meantime, we've taken a decision that we wanted to acquire what freehold land that we could in the vicinity of the Arzew South pit, the planned pit. So we've been in the process of discussions with local landholders, and we've reached agreement with many of them, and we've actually acquired quite a lot of ground now in that area. There are some other areas, particularly in the tailings storage area, that we need to acquire. But again, you know, these are things that we can work through during the course of this year. We were expecting at this point in time to move into a more formal permitting phase in the latter half of this year. But so far, so good. You know, our discussions and the support that we're getting from the various ministries in Turkey has been very positive, and we don't believe that we've got any major hurdles.
And once the mine is constructed and up and running and in production, prospective profits generated, how will these be utilised within the business? And could this enable the company to operate on a self-financing basis from 2013 onwards?
Yes, I mean, that's certainly our desire. We'd like to see the company attain a more robust financial position and some element of self-funding its further exploration is always desirable. You know, exploration is just one of these businesses that soaks up a lot of money and over a course of a long period of time, because exploration success, you know, doesn't come quickly, never does, and a lot of patience is required in this business, particularly when you're dealing in very competitive areas such as Western Turkey or Turkey in general. And we have to achieve an ability to retain an element of patience so that we can identify opportunities over the course of some years. And when an opportunity presents itself, we've got sufficient financial resources that we can chase it. And obviously, you know, coming back to the market consistently over decades is not something that many investors would be particularly patient with. But if we can develop one aspect of our business, and the mine at Kızıltepe is designed to do this, that can fund ongoing exploration requirements, at least in part, we would be doing very well for our shareholders in the long term.
Thank you, Kerem. And the company has now just celebrated its 10th year since initial formation. What are your aspirations and ambitions for the next 10 years?
It's been a very interesting 10 years. We've gone from essentially a research concept, looking at satellite data over Western Turkey to identify areas of potential hydrothermal alteration. And those areas, in some cases, do contain gold mineralization. And we were successful in picking up a number of licenses earlier on that were based on that research proposal. All the way through now to the point where we're completing a feasibility study for our first gold mine. So we've seen the company through from concept through to the point where we may well be pouring our first gold from our own gold plant. And that's, you know, a tremendous rate of progress. But what we'd like to do looking forward is to maintain that pace. And we'd certainly want to try to grow the company beyond, you know, its current position. And we'd want to establish ourselves as very much an important gold mining and exploration entity operating out of the Turkish region. And coming back to your earlier question about whether there may be any interests beyond Turkey, and I can answer that positively. I think, you know, once we've established ourselves as a gold producer in Turkey and we continue our exploration success elsewhere in the country, it's only natural for us to start looking further afield and areas of southeastern Europe and further afield going into parts of near Central Asia. So, you know, areas like Georgia and Azerbaijan. Those are all potentially interesting countries for us to work in. And we can certainly capitalize on our Turkish focus because of the long historic ties of Turkey to these regions, to southeastern Europe and into Central Asia. And we'd be doing very well to build on that.
Kerem, thanks very much indeed for giving Mine and Maven your time and for those concise answers. We'll be watching the company's developments very closely over the course of the rest of the year. And best of luck with everything you're doing.
Thank you very much, Malcolm.
We hope you enjoyed listening to this exclusive Mining Maven podcast interview, which is for information and educational purposes only and should not be considered as investment advice or a recommendation to buy shares in the company featured. Remember to go to our homepage at www.miningmaven.com to sign up for all our latest updates.